Morning. Today is Monday, July 6th, in the 14th week in ordinary time. We celebrate the memorial of Saint Maria Corelli. Please rise.
In love and in mercy.
I will espouse you in fidelity, and you shall know the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
Every day I will bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and highly to be praised. His greatness is unsearchable. Generation after generation praises your works and proclaims your might. They speak of the splendor of your glorious majesty and tell of your wondrous works. They discourse of the power of your terrible deeds and declare your greatness. They publish the fame of your abundant goodness and joyfully sing of your justice. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works.
The Lord is gracious and merciful.
Alleluia. Symbol of her death
the knife, but what's the flower for? Because Maria Goretti is both virgin and martyr. It was said that when the rapist was sent to jail for 27 years, Maria Goretti would visit him in his dreams and would bring him flowers. And during the conversation, it was said that the mother of Maria Goretti was present during that conversation. We pray to this saint, to Saint Maria Goretti, to stand up for the truth and not to let go of our faith in our love for our Lord. We always hear the saying, time is gold. And so if time is golden, we make schedules. We want to make schedules of our routine every day so that we would be productive. Even in the gospel about the Good Samaritan, wherein two persons passed by the man who has got robbed and left half dead on the road, a student and a priest. They have a schedule to follow. The student has to study. The priest has to do the worshiping. For them, it says, I cannot be late. I need to do this. They have a schedule to follow. And here comes the Lord being approached by an official, asking him to lay his hands on the daughter who just died. It was an urgent call. But even though the Lord was on an urgent call, he was rushing. His schedule was disrupted by a woman who has been in suffering from hemorrhage for 12 years. The Lord did not get angry. The Lord just asked, who touched me? Because he realized that power has gone out of him. But at that very moment, the most important person was the woman suffering because of hemorrhage. The Lord did not even say, get healed. Or the Lord gave that power to that lady because of that schedule at that time. She's the most important. This is the God that we have. A God who has time for us. A God who knows what we need. Why did Jesus have to raise the dead daughter back to life? Was it to show his own rising from the dead? Was he to give a second chance to the little girl because her vision is not yet done? Or was he to teach them that death is not the end of everything, that there is life after? I guess this is what the Lord's message is for all of us, that the Lord has time for us, the Lord gives us importance, the Lord listens, the Lord gives our every prayer. And at the same time, we also see that death is not the end of everything, that there's a wonderful life that awaits those who love the Lord. May we see clearly God's message, telling us, inspiring us, giving us the consolation that we need to hold on to our faith. Just as Maria Goretti, we need to give her own life, not to despise the Lord, not to dishonor the Lord, but to remain steadfast in faith. And she was rewarded with martyrdom, with virginity, with her love for the Lord. May we see clearly our own calling in the Lord. May we fight for the good, and let our faith show that the Lord is here to be adored, to be loved, and to be proclaimed towards people. We evangelize the Lord towards other people by the way we live our lives. May we be manifestation of our great love for God in our lives each day. Let us know. Let us present our needs and the needs of the world to God who gives us rest from our burdens.
For our church, as we continue to reveal God's saving message to God's least and lowliest, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
down among us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who are sick, for all who suffer from COVID-19, and for all who have died, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the young people in our midst who need employment, encouragement, and guidance, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
In silence, let us pray together with our patron Saint Martha for all our petitions. And for the intentions of Debbie Ramos, birthday, Tanya Antuna, birthday, for the souls of Thomas Tierney, Maria Luisa Conrado, and Oligario Teodoro, anniversary. For all this, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayers. We will be praying in thanksgiving for the gift of life, for the birthday of the beloved Son. We will be praying for the intentions of Arlene Corpin and Dina Corpin Mugulete. We will be praying for the repose of the soul of Demetria Landay, William Bayman, Renato Alvarade. We pray as well for the soul of Clayton Alonte, Domingo Cortez, and Yeso Cristo. O God, your Son proclaims peace to the nations. Grant that peace to our world today, and hear all these prayers which we lift up in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Before we offer the bread and wine that shall later become the precious body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, please take a few moments to prayerfully consider offering to the Lord. Come up the altar and drop your offerings to the box for parish operations and work of evangelization. Thank you so much. May God bless you and save your lives.
Let us say, be acceptable to God the Almighty God. For the praise and the glory of His name, for the rule and the glory of His holy church. May this salvation dedicated to your name glorify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our good and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you are glorified when your saints are praised, their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give us ardor to their faith, into their endurance, you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth, sing a new song in adoration, and we will all the host of angels cry out, us without end, be acclaimed. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the top of all holiness. May holy death of his gifts be prayed by sending down his spirit upon them like the new world, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks and broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection. And they will come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. And humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one with the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Archbishop, David, our auxiliary bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Denis, St. John Paul II, St. Teresa of Calcutta, St. Martha, St. Maria Goretti, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
On the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we declare to pray together, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, from sin and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us now offer and expect to one another the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Brothers and sisters, my dear friends, behold Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Behold him, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, have not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For those joining us by a live streaming, this is the time we pray our act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are fully present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you among all things, and I desire to receive it to my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive this sacrament, come at least spiritually to my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been advantaged by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Lord, we pray against the spread of COVID coronavirus. God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even many lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures of this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they can minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted, may they be restored for our soul. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these, Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We invite your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Prayer to St. Michael the Archangel. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. We are protected against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God make you king, we humbly pray. And O thou, the wings of the heavenly hosts, with the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander your world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Martha,
pray for us.
As you can see, we're now starting the process of changing of our conditions. We start with the whooping, so that if there will not be anything that or any treatment that there is no air condition in the church. So as they remove the other air condition, they will repair the roof and then replace it with the other air condition. So that is happening. Therefore, if you exit through this door, use the other one and avoid the corded, the red tape area where people are working, something might fall on their head. So just avoid that area. But still be cautious that you're crossing the street, there might be cars as well. Or better you can sit at the other door of the telephone. So we ask the Lord to continue to bless us, our parish, our children, all those prepared to receive the sacraments. The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you all in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended with holy deeds, to love and serve.
Thanks be to
God. Good morning, O